I remember being in Trafalgar Square once with the lovely Bill Pertwee. We were both very much the worse for wear, we really were. We'd been drinking all afternoon in the Colony Rooms in Dean Street, one of our favourite watering holes, you see. Anyway, I was staggering past the National Gallery and I tottered up to a police constable and I said, "Would you mind directing us to the nearest Alcoholics Anonymous, you see?" He said, "Why, sir, would you like to join?" I said, "No, I want to resign." I really have the most extraordinary fondness for Arthur Lowe, I really do. He's the most remarkably funny man I think I've ever met. I remember we were shooting one episode of Dad's Army, and it was the episode where we were converting the butcher's van into an armoured vehicle, you see. Well, Arthur was terribly jealous of Clive Dunn for getting to drive this van around, you see. He really wanted to drive it. So during his lunch break, he took the van for a spin around the farmyard, you see, and he ran over a cockerel, you see. Well, he was most distraught. He knocked on the farmer's door and he said, "I really am most awfully sorry. I'd like to replace your cockerel." And the farmer said, "Well, you're perfectly welcome. The hen's around the back." But who are we to cast stones? I mean, from what position of perfection do we hurl approbation? My marriage to Hattie was becoming thronged with shadows. I'd disappear for days on end. After a day's filming, I'd vanish to the jazz clubs and the pubs of Soho, you see. I'd arrive on the doorstep and Hattie would say, "Where have you been?" And I'd say, "Well, I've just popped to Ronnie Scott's, you see." And she'd say, "You've been missing for 3 days." His name was John Schofield, you see, a shortish chap. Car salesman, don't hold that against him. He moved in and never left. I remember Tony Hancock saying to me at the time, he said, "This is like Tigger arriving, John. This is like, you are Eeyore and he is Tigger, you see." And he'd read me the passage from the book, you know, his favourite book, Winnie the Pooh, you know. Eeyore encircled Tigger one way and then the other, and he said to Piglet and Pooh, "Who is this?" "It's a Tigger," said Piglet. "When is he leaving?" said Eeyore. He never left. I moved upstairs, and he downstairs with my wife. How can that happen? How can that happen? Is that what makes me tick? A complete incapacity to behave like any other normal human being and walk out, you see. Upstairs, well, downstairs, another man and my wife. Do I think that was wise?